Why the US was afraid of Qassem Soleimani, the mastermind who fought the US until he was killed. Before we begin, do us a favor by clicking that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell for more videos every day. Soleimani was born on March 11, 1957. At the time, Iran was ruled by a monarchy headed by Shah Mohammad Reza Pahlavi. He was born in the village of Qanat-Malak in Rabor, Kerman, around 700 miles from the Iranian capital, Tehran. He was born into a humble family of farmers in order to work in construction to pay a debt his father owed. In his free time, Soleimani attended sermons by Ali Khamenei, who went on to become Iran's second and current supreme leader. In the lead-up to the Iranian Revolution of 1979, he also worked to organize demonstrations in opposition to the Shah. Following the Iranian Revolution, which ousted the Shah and established the Islamic Republic of Iran, Soleimani joined the Islamic Revolutionary Guards Corps, IRGC. Shortly after, he was sent to the front lines in the Iran-Iraq War, 1980-1988. He emerged a distinguished figure in the Iranian armed forces after carrying out a series of reconnaissance missions in Iraq. In 1998, Khamenei made Soleimani the head of the Quds Force, a unit within the IRGC which handles Iran's foreign military operations. He kept a relatively low profile for a while, but in 2005 Soleimani became more prominent in Iraq's Shia Muslim political groups. In 2010, Soleimani reportedly sent a message to General David Petraeus, who was head of the US forces in Iraq at the time, saying the following: "You should know that I, Qassem Soleimani, control the policy for Iran with respect to Iraq, Lebanon, Gaza, and Afghanistan." In 2011, as the Syrian civil war broke out, Soleimani sent Iranian-backed militias into the country to support President Bashar Assad. Iran became a key ally of Syria through the war under Soleimani's leadership. He was reportedly involved in drawing up a strategy for Assad to help him with violent crackdowns on opposition groups in Syria, as well as training government-allied militias in the country. However, it was his prominent role in fighting ISIS in Iraq that led to his wider recognition, and won Soleimani widespread support inside Iran. His efforts in fighting the terrorist group were also recognized by Western media. He was a household name, often appearing on television and generally popular among the public. In 2016, a poll showed that 76% of Iranians held a favorable view of him. Shia militia fighters also made a music video about him, in which soldiers are pictured painting graffiti portrait of Soleimani's face on a wall, whilst music in the background sings his praises. As might be expected, he was not seen as favorably in the West. The Quds Force was declared a terrorist organization in 2007, and Soleimani himself was sanctioned. Rumors around his death circulated several times previously, including in 2006 when a military airplane crashed in northwestern Iran, and in 2012 after a bombing in Damascus killed top aides of Assad. But 3rd of January, 2020, Thursday night, early Friday morning in Iraq, the US military announced Soleimani had died in an airstrike attack on Baghdad airport. The reports were confirmed by Iranian state media. Iran's supreme leader Ali Khamenei has promised to retaliate following the strike, and said severe revenge awaits the criminals who have stained their hands with his and other martyrs' blood, but it remains unclear how Iran plans to carry out its promised revenge. Thank you for watching. Did you like the video? If you did, leave a like and share this with your friends. Want to see another video? Just comment below.